In these precious moments, we realize what we feel and know in our heart, that Christmas is really about the Christ. It is Christmas and some of the cherished traditions of the season that remind us that we, like the wise men of old, should seek the Christ and lay before him the most precious of gifts, a broken heart and a contrite spirit. We should offer him our love. We should give him our willingness to take upon ourselves his name and walk in the path of discipleship. We should promise to remember him always, to emulate his example, and to go about doing good. Of course, we do not need a Christmas holiday or Christmas traditions to remember Jesus Christ, our Savior. But the celebrations of Christmas can help remind us of him. The hallowed Christmas season can be an opportunity, and should be one, to recommit to keep the fire of the Spirit and the glory of the Son of God burning in our hearts every day throughout the year. This is a wonderful time of the year. It may not be perfect, but if Christmas can point our hearts toward our Savior, we can rejoice even in the imperfections of the season.
Sure. Christmas is a glorious season of the year. It's also a busy time for most of us. It's my hope and prayer that we may not become so caught up in the pressures of the season that we've placed our emphasis on the wrong things and miss the simple joys of commemorating the birth of the Holy One of Bethlehem. Finding the real joy of Christmas comes not in the hurrying and the scurrying to get more done. We find the real joy of Christmas when we make the Savior the focus of the season. Born in a stable, cradled in a manger, He came forth from heaven to live on earth as mortal man and to establish the kingdom of God. His glorious gospel reshaped the thinking of the world. He lived for us, and He died for us. What can we in return give to Him? I love the words penned by the English poet, Christina Rossetti. What can I give Him, poor as I am? If I were a shepherd, I'd bring a lamb. If I were a wise man, I would do my part. Yet what can I give Him? Give my heart. Our celebration of Christmas should be a reflection of the love and selflessness taught by the Savior. Giving, not getting, brings to full bloom the Christmas spirit. We feel more kindly one to another. We reach out in love to help those less fortunate. Our hearts are softened. Enemies are forgiven. Friends remembered. And God obeyed. The spirit of Christmas illuminates the picture window of the soul. We look out upon the world's busy life, become more interested in people than in things. To catch the real spirit of Christmas, we need only drop the last syllable and becomes the spirit of Christ. In short, the Christmas spirit is the Christ spirit that makes our heart glow in brotherly love and friendship and prompts us to kind deeds of service. It is the spirit of the gospel of Jesus Christ, obedience to which will bring peace on earth, because it means goodwill toward all men. Thank you. How much better the world would be if we all gave gifts of understanding and compassion, of service and friendship, of kindness and gentleness. As the Christmas season envelops us with all its glory, may we, as did the wise man, seek a bright particular star to guide us in our celebration of the Savior's birth. May we all make the journey to Bethlehem in spirit, taking with us a tender, caring heart as our gift to the Savior. My brothers and sisters, may one and all have a joy-filled Christmas. Such is my hope and my prayer. In the sacred name of our Savior, Jesus Christ, amen.